Hey, what's up everybody? This is the boy JC from my own pocket. How are y'all doing today? Alright, I'm just doing a follow-up with the dual rank RAM that I have inside my Asus G15 Advanced Edition gaming laptop. As you guys watched my previous video, the dual rank RAM that I have inside is a Timetec, and I just want to do some follow-up on the frame rates. And I would like to say personally, I think this dual rank RAM has been doing a pretty good job in terms of frame rates. Okay, let me get into some game real quick. For example, for God of War that I'm playing right now, I usually go to my settings, and it all depends on the type of resolution they put. You're gonna get different frame rates. So I have an AMD, my PC got an AMD chip, so the different configurations. It doesn't support DLSS, that's for NVIDIA. So if you have a Radeon chip, you only can use Fidelity FX, and so that's basically what it is. So as you can see, when I'm going to the options screen right here, getting the FPS's up into the 100s, see? 117, 119. So for gameplay wise, when I use render scaling, as you can see right there, I got it at 1080p. And if you look closely at the FPS while I'm moving around, it does a pretty good job keeping it at least in the high 80s, high 90s, and 100s. So that's the beautiful thing with the dual rank RAM. It gives you high FPS's, very consistent. But the problem with dual rank is it tends to keep the GPU running a little bit longer and it gets warmer. So my advice, get like a cooling pad. But you can see right here, move around with Kratos, I keep messing the names up. You can see right here, it's the frame rates are pretty consistent, which is pretty cool. Now, let me go ahead and change the resolution. Okay, you know, the higher the resolution, the less FPS you may get. So let me go back into here. I have a 2K monitor. So for 2K, it's 2560 by 1440, as you can see right there, the output resolution. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna crank it all the way up. So now the rendering resolution is gonna be 2K. I remember previously it was 1080p, now I got it at 2K. But one thing I noticed, if you look at the top left corner where the FPS is, it's still peaking in the 100s when it's not doing anything. So now I've got the rendering at 2K. Oops, sorry, forgot to do that. Now I've got it at 2K. Okay, let's see the FPS with Kratos. As you see, as I move around a little bit, it's in the 80s, which is not bad at all. High 70s. It frequently dropped to 60, but not so much. But it maintains at a high 70 to at least 80s. Now, when I do some action, it may see a little drop. It's not that bad. It still keeps it up at least in the 70s. See, go as 60s. But it's still pretty consistent. At least it's go back into the 80s. Now, let me try the same action again, but only this time at 1080p. Wait a minute. Whoa, wait a minute. I was using Radeon graphics. See that? I usually got it in the Radeon RX, not the Radeon TM graphics. Let me see if there's a difference. Okay, I got it at 2K using the Radeon RX 6800M graphics. Oh, it's not gonna make a difference because I didn't restart the game. So anyway, so apparently it was still at the Radeon RX 6800M, but look like I accidentally put it on the Radeon, but it won't take effect until the game is resetted. So overall, it's still running on the Radeon 6800M. But anyway, back to what I was saying before I got distracted a little bit. Back to the display. I'm going back to 1080p, as you can see right here. And then let's look at the FPS's. See, at 1080p, I'm getting a nice peak. Look at that. Now let's do some action with Kratos. High 90s, high 80s, 90s, and they're going to the 100s. So it keeps it high with the dual rank RAM. Especially if you got a AMD chip inside, for some reason with dual rank RAMs and the AMD chip, it just works better for some reason. You get a nice bump in FPS. And it's been pretty smooth. As you can see, there's no lagging, there's no stuttering, nothing at all. So dual rank RAMs are pretty cool. And if you're gonna buy a dual rank, if you're gonna buy a RAM, make sure the RAM on the label says R2. R2 means that's dual rank. You can see like one R, that means it's single rank. Single rank RAMs is more consistent. Not just say more consistent. You may get a little bit faster or a little bit more. Let me put it this way. Your upload is going to be a little bit faster with a single rank, but in terms of getting high FPS and consistency, you're not going to get it. So that's why I say with the dual rank RAM I'm using, when I use 1080p, I get in the high 100s. But let me go back to like 2K and wrap up this video real quick. Going back to the rendering resolution at 2K, it still produces good FPS. Look at that. At least the 70s. Getting the high 70s, and then because I'm doing movement action now, just casually just spinning around the camera or getting at rest, you get like 80s. But overall, performance wise, dual ranks are phenomenal if you're looking to get a high FPS and consistency. But it tends to make the GPU run a little bit harder, as you can see right here in the GPU. I'll be using right here at least 98% of it, and 99 fluctuates, and the temperature will be like in the high 80s. So I'm gonna have to slap on my cooling pad to keep it cool. But overall, I think it's pretty decent. I think with the dual rank RAMs, that's the way to go. If you want a dual rank RAM, is great, especially if you do like video editing and other little things, because you got the extra set of RAMs in the back, so the GPU is going to run perfectly fine. I think I'm saying it right. But it all depends on brands. Different brands do it differently. This one I'm using is a Timetec, so bear that in mind. So I'm getting another dual rank RAM this week, so I'm going to do another test with that one, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for tuning in. Love you guys. My channel is growing. 1,244 subscribers. And I thank you guys for your love and support. Keep subscribing. Keep sharing my videos. Keep on liking it. Like I said, I'm gonna change my channel in a few days. Change my name and everything. So show me some support. Leave your comments. Let me know what you think. Alright. Thanks for tuning in. Love you guys.